Class 9 physics to be continued. Numericals on gravitation. First question is, a stone is released from the top of a tower of height 19.6 meter. Calculate its final velocity. In question, we have calculate final velocity of stone. Stone is released from the top of a tower. Released from the top of a tower means initial velocity becomes zero. Because we know that when a object starts his journey from rest, then initial velocity becomes zero. Second sentence, we know that if a object end his journey from rest, then final velocity becomes zero. We have two velocities, first initial velocity, second final velocity. Initial velocity, velocity of start his journey. Final velocity, velocity of end his journey. Here we want to calculate final velocity, and means value of v. Given that initial velocity is equal to zero, because stone is released from rest. Height of tower given s is equal to 19.6 meter. We know that acceleration applied by the earth means acceleration due to gravity. Small g 9.8 meter per second square. G is a type of acceleration which is provided by earth. Then third equation of motion. V is equal to u square plus 2gs. V square is equal to u square plus 2gs. Why? Sine of plus. Because stone is in direction of gravity. Means downward motion. Direction of gravity is downward. And direction of stone is also downward. Then here we take plus g. Then v square is equal to u square plus 2gs. V square is equal to value of u 0, 0 square plus 2 into value of small g 9.8 into value of s, means height of tower, distance of tower, displacement of tower, s 19.6. 2 into 9.8, 19.6. B square is equal to 19.6 into 19.6. V is equal to under root 19.6 into 19.6. V is equal to 19.6 meter per second. This is answer of final velocity of stone. Now second question. Here stone is thrown vertically upward. Vertically upward means opposite direction of acceleration due to gravity. One thing clear that here we take g as a negative, because direction of gravity and direction of stone, these are opposite to each other. Given that initial velocity of stone is 40 meter per second, small g given 10 meter per second square, find the maximum height reached by the stone. Next question, what is net displacement of stone and the total distance covered by the stone? Here given that u is equal to 40 meter per second, final velocity 40 meter per second. If a object end his journey from rest, then final velocity becomes zero. so that final velocity of a stone is equal to 0 meter per second. Small g taken as negative because direction of a stone is opposite influence of gravity minus 10. Height unknown quantity to be calculated. Third equation of motion, v square is equal to u square plus 2gh. Value of v 0, 0 square plus u square means 40 square plus 2 into g means minus 10 into h. 1600 plus minus 20 into h. Minus 20h plus 1600 is equal to 0. Minus 20h is equal to minus 1600. H is equal to 80 meter. This is the maximum height reached by the stone is 80 meter. Then net displacement 0 because stone is again reached at a final position. Means stone is first case thrown vertically upward. Then again stone is vertically downward. Then initial point and final point overlap to each other. Minimum distance of point is 0 because definition of displacement, shortest distance between initial point and final point means minimum distance. Minimum distance of point is 0, then net displacement is equal to 0. But total distance 80 meter in upward direction and 80 meter in downward direction, total 160 meter covered by the stone. This is total distance, but displacement is 0. Now third question. Calculate the force of gravitation between the earth and the sun given that the mass of earth 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg, mass of sun 2 into 10 to the power 30 kg. The average distance between them means earth and sun 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 meter. We know that universal law of gravitation between two masses of m1 and m2. F is equal to capital G M1 M2 by R square, where F is the gravitational force between two objects, here object naming as M1 and M2, capital G universal gravitation constant, value cannot changes, value of capital G 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11, M1 mass of earth 6 into 10 to the power 24, M2 mass of sun 2 into 10 to the power 30. Distance between earth and sun means average distance 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 whole square. Here solving F is equal to 80.04 into 10 to the power 13 divided by 2.25 into 10 to the power 22. Then F is equal to 30.557 into 10 to the power 21 Newton. Means gravitational force between earth and sun is 35.57 into 10 to the power 21 Newton. This is gravitational force act between earth and sun.